Hello gamers, Odyssey checking in. Today I am making something a little bit different. Instead of going for a review for a classic game or one of the new AAA games, I decided to focus my attention into a different section of the market, and I am talking about the visual novels market. Visual novels are not very popular on the Western side of gaming. However, we do see a few once and then. I noticed that the most visual novels are kind of the same. The most basic example that we have of a visual novel is the so-called dating simulators, where you basically just mindless click through a story in order to get pretty pictures of anime girls. And admit it, who doesn't want to see that? But it's just pretty much mindless clicking, and sometimes there is no background story into that. On the other hand, we have these other kind of novels where you manage stats for a character or for whatever. By managing different stats, you change the story and may change its outcome in the end. However, these two basic formulas have been so overused in the market, and I mean overused, then basically you're seeing another story and another one that is exactly the same as the first one, and there is no big difference into it, so there is a point when you actually don't want to play them anymore. Because, you know, stat managing is not fun, it's repetitive, and if the story is not engaging, then just mindless clicking is not going to cut it. However, in the middle of these two giants on the visual novel market, we have this new trend that pays special attention on delivering an entertaining story, of making an actual novel out of it, and mixing gaming elements into it, interaction with the user. So, on one hand, you have a story that tries to engage you emotionally, tries to engage you with the characters like in a good book, and that's the whole point. And once you're engaged, they let you play with the story. Some of them gives you multiple endings. Some of them give you different options, rewards for completing all of the story. And in the end, you kind of feel... how can I say it? Once you finish one, it's like finishing a book. It takes a special place within you, within yourself. And this kind of jewels is one that I am reviewing today, which is called Analog, a Hate Story. Analog has all of these elements. It has a very, very good writing. It has a very good premise. Just picture this: you are a space investigator set in the year 4000 and something, and they send you to find out what happened to a ship that disappeared 600 years ago. And that ship was carrying, it's called a generation ship, so it was carrying generations of people throughout the journey. And you can see the briefing, this is the intro of the game, and when you get there, your immediate interaction with the game is in some sort of weird Linux command console, when some basic commands actually work, and you gotta start figuring out what happened. You wake up the computer artificial intelligence, this lovely character, and she will help you go through the logs of the crew to try to find out what happens. The best approach on this is that you don't get the direct story. It's kind of reading multiple diaries from multiple people across the ship in the different social levels, and you discover how for some reason they have a society change from being a futuristic 27th century society to some weird classic Neo-Confucian retrograde society. I mean, it sounds complex, but it's really engaging. It's really it's not a difficult lecture, all right? I'm sorry, it's not a difficult reading. It's very easy to go through, and every two or three logs you can chat with the artificial intelligence in here, who happens to like cosplays, of course. There has to be a certain level of fan service, and it doesn't go boring. It actually, you just want to keep reading and reading, and this is definitely a must have if you get a chance. You can catch it on a sale on Steam, or actually it's pretty cheap right now. That is not all. The plot thickens. You find, spoiler alert, you find a second hidden artificial intelligence which tells you a different story about what happened, and you gotta decide who's right, who's lying to you, and in the end, due to some event in the middle of the game, you have to decide which one you want to save. Now, that doesn't may sound like too much, it may sound a little cliche, however, the best part of it is that, well, you have like 5 different endings for this game, and there is another expansion which is called Hate Plus. It's not expansion, it's actually a separate game, but you can export your save file from the first game with all your decisions and play it on the second game, which is awesome, and you have a whole different experience on the second game. Actually, I'm making a separate video for that second game, for Hate Plus, because here is an interesting fact, is one of the few games that has the one achievement that nobody on Steam has. Yep, that's right, it has one achievement that nobody has, and we'll check that later on the video. Well, I cannot tell a lot without spoiling the whole story. My journey through the visual novel part of the gaming industry has been weird, but finding these beautiful crafted games with beautiful stories, with such developed characters, for me it was awesome. I mean, I literally spent like 6 hours on the first game, just reading and chatting with the artificial intelligence, and it works on the part that you feel emotionally compromised. So give it a try, you might find that you actually like these kind of games, and in the end, you may find that there is an avid reader inside of you, and I'm pretty sure there is. And well, if you like this video, then remember to like this video, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button up there so that you can get more content. Alright gamers, hope you like it, this is Odyssey checking out, see you out there.